Welcome everyone. In the next lecture on the mean and the variance, what we discovered in the previous lecture is we covered the mean and variance and their formulae and one problem based on the discrete random variable. Okay. Now in this lecture, I am going to cover the problem based on the continuous random variable. Look at this problem. I am purposefully taking a problem where the variance is expected. Some university style questions. Okay, so let's come to this example. Here a continuous random variable x has a probability density function given by f of x is equal to a plus bx for 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. If the mean of distribution is 1, find a and b. Here I am not asking to calculate you the variance, but I am leaving this part or say calculating the variance on you as an homework. Okay, we will proceed for getting the a and b, and for that we are using the mean of the distribution is 1. Okay, so just a minute, the mean of the distribution is 1/3, sorry, in the question paper it is 1/3. Okay, again we are going to follow two ways for getting the two equations, because there are two unknowns are present. One is integration from minus infinity to plus infinity f of x dx is equal to 1, this is one property, and second is e of x is equal to integration from minus infinity to plus infinity x into f of x dx. These two properties we are going to use. Now you can see the f of x is defined in the interval 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, hence we need to restrict these integrals. So integration from 0 to 1, f of x is a plus bx dx is equal to 1. So hence what I am getting, integration of a will be a into x, and bx integration is bx square upon 2, limits from 0 to 1 is equal to 1. So when we substitute the upper limit, we get a plus b by 2 is equal to 1, because for lower limit both the terms are going to be 0. So leave this. Now, so this is my equation number 1. Now come to this, I am just rearranging the formula. Integration from 0 to 1, x into f of x is a plus bx dx is equal to e of x. Okay, so the value of e of x is 1/3, so this is ax plus bx square dx is equal to, value of e of x is 1/3, substitute that. Now integration of ax is ax square by 2, the value of bx square is bx cube by 3, limits from 0 to 1 is equal to 1/3. So when I substitute the upper limit, I am getting a by 2 plus b by 3 is equal to 1/3. This is our second equation. Okay, so you can rearrange this equation as you can have this LCM. The LCM is 6, so this becomes 3a plus 2b is equal to 6. 6 upon 3 is, is it okay? So this is equation number 2. Now solve equation 1 and 2. So how we can solve? We multiply this one by 3 and subtract it from the equation number 2. So 3a plus 2b is equal to 2 minus 3a plus 3/2 into b is equal to 3. So plus 3 minus 3 get cancelled. 2b minus 3/2b. So this is 2 minus 3/2 into b is equal to 3. So 2 minus 3/2 is what? Yes, 2 2's are 4, 4 minus 3, that is 1. So 1/2b is equal to 3. So this, there is a subtraction, 2 minus 3, so that gives you minus 1. Okay, so here it is minus 1. So hence the value of b is minus 2. Now substitute the value of b is equal to minus 2 in equation number 1. What I am getting, a plus b is minus 2 upon 2 is equal to 1. So this get cancelled, we get a minus 1 is equal to 1, so a is equal to 2. So the value of a is 2 and b is equal to minus 2. Now substitute these values in the given probability density function. So our density function becomes f of x is equal to 2 minus 2x for 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. And for this function you are supposed to calculate the variance. For getting the variance, what are expected here? Look at here. E of x is already given in this problem, which is 1/3. So you are supposed to calculate e of x square, and further you have to calculate e of x square minus e of x bracket square. This way you can calculate the variance in this given question. Okay, now let's move to the next problem. Let's come to the second problem. The distribution function of a random variable x is capital F of x is equal to 1 minus 1 plus x into e raised to minus x for x greater than or equal to 0. Find mean and variance. But let me clear you one thing. Of course, this problem based on the continuous random variable, as they expressed function of distribution function of x in this way. So this is a problem based on the continuous random variable. Okay. Second thing, for mean and variance, we require to calculate e of x, which is nothing but mean, and for variance, one more term is necessary, that is e of x square. In both the formulas, we require the probability density function, that is small f of x, and here they are giving a distribution function of a random variable. Now, how to get this probability density function? It's very simple. So probability density function is nothing but d by dx of probability distribution function. Okay, that means derivative of capital F of x is our probability density function. So here it is, d by dx of 1 minus 1 plus x into e raised to minus x. So this is a constant, of course it is 0, so minus u into v. So first term as it is, derivative of the second term, that is minus 1 into e raised to minus x, okay, plus derivative of the first term, derivative of 1 is 0, plus derivative of x is 1 into e raised to minus x. Now let's take the minus sign inside, this minus and minus become plus. So 1 into e raised to minus x, e raised to minus x, okay, plus x into e raised to minus x. This minus and plus becomes minus, 1 into e raised to minus x, e raised to minus x. So this get cancelled. Hence our probability density function becomes f of x is equal to x into e raised to minus x for x greater than or equal to 0. Now we are supposed to calculate the mean and the variance. I am leaving that part as an homework for you. I hope you will able to get the e of x, which is nothing but mean. Once you calculate e of x square, you will easily calculate the term of variance. Thank you.